Meredith, here's my first question for you. How are you fostering innovation at Forbes?
I think innovation is about a few things. It's first and foremost about really focusing on what's the problem that you're trying to solve for your customer. In our case, that's a consumer and that's a marketer, and we are relentlessly focused on, are we delivering on the needs of those customers first, and then surrounding that issue for us with the right talent, with a group of people who can think, who can execute on new ideas, who can work together across departments, and that's what's working for us.
Why has Forbes Brand Voice proved so successful, and what are some of the latest innovations to the program?
And Brand Voice is 3 years old in a couple of months, and it took us, full disclosure, it took us some time to have success with it, but as we sort of close out the third year of it being a big part of our product set, we can look back and say it has indeed been successful, and particularly for one reason, and that is that it really does meet the needs of all three constituents in the media business today. So it meets the needs of the consumer by recognizing that content today in a digital social world is part of a meritocracy. Consumers simply want the best information possible, and in some cases that can come from a brand. A brand might have more domain expertise than anybody else on that topic, and Brand Voice allows that brand's expertise to be positioned right alongside the expertise of journalists and transparently labeled as such. For a marketer, what Brand Voice gives, what the problem that Brand Voice solves, is that it allows a marketer to be part of the conversation and to put its thought leadership, its expertise, in a place where the conversation is already happening. In the old world, where you could buy only an adjacency, the marketer was at best next to where that conversation between the journalist and the consumer was happening. And for the journalist or the publisher, Brand Voice is fixing the business model problem. We all agree that banners are a complicated thing from which to arrive at the right business model for journalism. They are necessary, they will continue, but they're not the only way for ad-supported journalism to support itself. And Brand Voice, for us, has solved a problem of allowing us to capture a premium for what we do best, which is allowing our journalists to connect to consumers and bring marketers into that conversation.